I'm Joe Barloon. I'm a senior at the University of Northern Iowa. I'm majoring in electronic media and minoring in journalism. I didn't get my first urge to do video production or audio video production until I was a senior in high school. I was going to be a doctor and go to medical school for the longest time, but I had a good year in speech at Allstate Radio, and one of the men that was judging my performance said, "You need to sell that voice, figure out a way to do it, because that's what's going to make your money." So ever since then, I've been pursuing that kind of career, broadcasting. The reason I came to UNI was because of family tradition. My mom has 10 siblings, and of the 8 that went to college, all of them came to UNI. Every one of my cousins, for the exception of 2, have gone to UNI. And so I told myself I was not coming here because everybody else in the family did. But after visiting UNI, I fell in love, and there was no other choice. I had to come here. I knew that electronic media was a way for me to enter the broadcasting career. I wasn't sure what else there was for me to do for that line of work, and that's kind of what I landed on. But I picked up a journalism minor as well because news interests me. In the field that I'm studying, visual communications is very important. The way people tell stories nowadays are through video. There's no way you're going to see a newscast or be able to take anything away from it unless you hear and see the footage. People today come to expect a video. They go online for videos. They go to the television videos, and that you can't get away from them. It's just the way that news is gathered and produced now. Well, anything I've done at UNI has only solidified my career path. I have not done an activity here that said, no, you're not in the right place. Everything from Cedar River Productions to UNI Sketch to where I work in the ITTC, everything has pointed me where I'm at now. My internship is great, and I feel at home. Well, any production class I've taken has been very enjoyable. My documentary course has been my favorite production class so far. I really love my journalism classes, and because that's more the field I want to go into. Anything with Ronnie Bankston has been great. He's a great guy, great professor. His classes can be kind of difficult, but I found that by talking with him, you take so much more away from class when you have a class with him. Well, right now, I do a lot of kind of freelance stuff on my own where it's just for fun because I don't have anybody paying me to make any videos. And so anything I do is just for the experience or for my reel. And so right now, I'm lining up a shoot with a band to make a music video. I'm going to be working on that hopefully the next couple weeks to go to some shows of theirs. And they understand that, well, I understand that they don't have any money and they're not going to pay me, but I realize that it's going to be good for my reel. So it's something new that I've never done before. And so this music video is going to be very exciting. Like, free work is very important because there's no way to build your reel if you're not doing something. So you have to kind of take the first couple jobs you do with a grain of salt and just do the work. Do a great job even though you're not getting paid for it. And then that way, when you get to the point where you can start asking for money, you have that work to back up your experience. Well, I'm going to graduate a semester early from UNI. I will be done in this coming December. And so that's kind of nerve-wracking because I've only been here 3.5 years, and I feel like that's just not quite long enough. I love going to school, but what I'm looking for is I want to start applying for jobs. I want to make connections in news companies and news organizations because I really want to run camera or direct something in the news department. I love the idea of being able to come to work every day and do something different. There's not going to be one day that's the same because things change. News is news. Well, I haven't technically started searching for jobs yet, but I hear the horror stories about, oh, you have a degree in electronic media, you want to go into news and broadcasting, you're not going to find a job. You're going to be poor. So that kind of worries me, but I think with the experience I've got and with the personality I have, that hopefully somebody will take me in. In 5 years, I hope to see myself on a well-developed news team and working to produce a nightly newscast. Well, I grew up in a small town, and I realized that is not going to be where all the news is going to be and where the jobs are, so I want to move to a bigger metropolitan area and get my start at a larger city. Well, finding a job is what scares me the most. Is I know it's a hectic thing, and I know it's crazy to think about it, because, you know, I've had odd jobs growing up and stuff, but actually getting my career is what worries me, because being able to jump in and take that, I'm going to be working here for 35, 40 years or longer, is kind of a scary thought, you know? So I want to find that job that's going to be the right fit. I don't want to do a whole bunch of jump around. I want to jump in and get the correct thing first. I don't know, because I figured you probably move from job to job. You have your next job before you leave your other one. I mean, I don't want to end up losing that first job. I want to be able to make the decisions on my own and go when I'm ready. Of course, if it was a job that made me want to come to work every day and a day didn't feel like work, then I can see myself staying there forever. Well, plan B, if news doesn't cut it, I really want to go into being a production assistant, maybe working with an advertising company or agency, and do some writing. I really love getting a chance to write and create my own work, and then hopefully I'd be able to write and then go and produce that footage on my own. Cedar River Productions has been a great learning opportunity for me. When I took an executive position last year, and it's one of those times where it's your baptism of fire. If you don't know it, you have to figure it out and get it done, because everybody else is looking to you to know what you're doing. And so by doing that and having that pressure put on me, I learned so much last year on my own, just having to get it done and meet deadlines. And so that was a great learning experience. And by doing that, hopefully I have the skills needed to stick with a job and get those deadlines. I think going out into the workforce is going to be almost the same exact experience as I had with Cedar River Productions. You're going to have to know what you're doing, and because they're not going to have time to teach you. I mean, your employers aren't going to have the time to teach you every step. You're going to have to come in with knowledge, and if you don't know, you're going to have to figure it out fast, otherwise they're going to find somebody else. If I had talked to an employer right now, I would have to highlight all my experiences that I've had and show him or her that I've worked on a whole lot of stuff and that I've got what it takes. And hopefully through that interview, I'd be able to show my personality and how good a character I have.